to today's episode of the Law Show. You know that on this show we give you the law so that you can understand your legal rights and you'll be able to actually enforce them. Now, all of you know that I like litigation. I like suing people and I like seeing people get sued. You know, I mean, it makes my day. So, but there's a drawback. Drawback is sometimes litigation, you can spend months in court. Sometimes you can spend weeks in court. But most times, most cases in Nigeria take years in court. So how can someone get quick justice without spending many years in court? How to get quick justice without spending many years in court? We will be looking at that. I've got a very, very special guest in the studio. Her name is Erakoba Ilavari. I hope I pronounced your name right. Erakoba Ilavari. Erakoba Ilavari has a bachelor's degree from the University of Benin in law. Then she went to the law school and then went to the University of Hertfordshire in Hartsfield in the United Kingdom, where she bagged an LLM in commercial and maritime law. Oh my goodness. Commercial and maritime law. That's a deep one. Besides that, she is an associate of the Chartered Institute of Arbitrators, both in the UK and in Nigeria. And then she is currently the president of Princely Solicitors and Arbitrators in Benin. Princely Solicitors and Arbitrators in Benin. Erakoba, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You have a long list of accolades.
Thank you.
How do you do this you went to UK, you got LLM in commercial and maritime law. I studied in the UK, I did some studies in the UK, and I know that studying in the UK is not a piece of cake. I mean, you have to study, you study. There's no blocking, there's no shukuli. You know, there's nothing like that. You don't know lecturers, you have to really study. And then, so you did an LLM in commercial and maritime law, and then you're an associate Chartered Institute of Arbitrators. Tell us about what is this Chartered Institute of Arbitrators. What is that?
Okay, the Chartered Institute of Arbitrators.
You have to raise your voice a little bit.
The Chartered Institute of Arbitrators UK,
yes,
is an arbitration institution where professionals from different fields, including law,
yes,
are trained as arbitrators.
Okay.
So arbitrators are neutrals that help parties in a multi-door an alternative dispute resolution situation resolve their dispute without going to court.
Okay, so alternative dispute resolution as an alternative to litigation, is
yes,
that?
It is.
So litigation is the one that everybody knows. If I have a problem with you, I sue you to court. That's what everybody knows. That's the popular means to resolve it. So a judge sits over it and decides, okay, Rakoba is right or Dele is right.
Yes.
Judge can never say both of us are right. So one person leaves with a bad feeling.
Yes, it does.
One person always wins. You know, two people don't win. Is that both loses or one wins?
One wins.
Okay.
Yes.
But there's no situation where the two will win in a court. So if I have a claim, the other person has a counterclaim, so it's either my claim succeeds and the counterclaim fails.
Sometimes it's not always the case. Sometimes
in litigation,
yes, sometimes you have a situation where half of the first person's suit is dismissed,
yes,
and the other half of the other person's suit is being accepted. So,
okay, so, yeah, so there's a 50-50.
There can be a 50-50, but
okay,
it's not very common.
But with alternative dispute resolution, which is an alternative to litigation.
Yes.
You said to me that, you know, everybody wins.
Yes, the win-win situation.
It's a win-win situation.
Yes, it's always a win-win situation.
Mm.
Parties do not have to live with that feeling of grievance. Yes, because at the end of the day, they get to see the point of wrong and they get to accept the point of wrong. Then they get to fashion out a means of solution going forward for both parties.
Okay, so you ADR, alternative dispute resolution. So this can help people to resolve their disputes rather quicker than litigation.
Okay, I think where a better place for us to start would be what itself is the concept of alternative dispute resolution, what we popularly call ADR. So ADR, as we have earlier said, is an alternative dispute resolution. Alternative in the sense alternative to litigation. So ADR is alternative dispute resolution to litigation or against litigation. It means that apart from going to court, there are other means of resolving disputes. So when both parties, especially commercial parties, when they have dispute arising from their contracts, obligations, instead of going to court and spend many years in court, they can adopt more flexible ways of resolving their disputes. These flexible ways could include arbitration, mitigation, facilitation, conciliation, mediation, and a whole lot of them, as we now have them world over. But specifically in Nigeria, we are adapted to alternative to arbitration and conciliation, because currently we have the Arbitrators and Conciliatory Act in Nigeria. So that's what we are most adapted to. And so we have gone ahead to equally establish institutions that can help people train to become professionals in this field. Other than that, we have springing up mediation and negotiation. So you now have the Chartered Institute of Mediators and Chartered Institute of Negotiators. They have equally sprung up along the line. They are equally adequate means of resolving disputes, especially commercial disputes.
Okay, so let's just, for the purpose of the viewers, sometimes I like to break, you know, things down, so someone who's making a note can actually, get it and follow. The ADR, you said there are alternative dispute resolution. The advantage is that, it can achieve results faster. Is that granted?
There are many advantages to ADR as against litigation.
Okay.
But the most foremost advantage is the fact that it is very quick.
It's quick.
Very, very quick.
Okay.
It is very, very quick. Because somewhere along the line, ADR systems are able to get parties to cooperate. That's the cooperation that is usually lacking in the litigative system.
Okay.
So they are able to get parties to cooperate, and it is that cooperation that brings about the speed in ADR. Another reason why ADR is usually quick is because, unlike the regular court, where you go to a court and you file your cases through a registrative process, and other people come file their cases through that same registrative process,
yes,
the ADR is usually not like that.
Okay.
In the original sense of ADR, you identify a neutral.
Okay.
So, say for example, an arbitrator.
Yes.
You identify a neutral. You and the other person resolve to go to the neutral and say, sit over our matter, we have a dispute, we want you to help us find a common ground.
Yes.
Or either party gets a neutral who in turn helps them to identify a third neutral who listens to their matter and gives them a possible solution to their problems.
Okay.
But recently, what we are having, we are now having a structured ADR system. Because even the states have, the judiciaries have understood that the courts are getting more bothersome with matters every day. More disputes are being enlisted and the courts have become congested. So okay. In a bid to decongest the courts,
yes,
we now have judiciary-centric ADR systems. These are called multi-door courthouses.
Okay.
So in the multi-door courthouses, the judiciary pre-identify neutrals and register them in the courthouses. Then when a matter is being referred or when a matter comes up naturally in the multi-door system, the pre-identified neutrals are called upon to sit over a particular matter. So this still makes it faster than the normal court process, which already has millions and millions of cases already waiting in the courts.
Okay, so you've made some points now. First is, There are basically two streams of the ADR thing. You talked about the ones relating to commercial dispute resolution. So anyone who is watching, business people, you know, who have disputes, business disputes, instead of going to court and spending, you know, 7 years to try to resolve the issue of the container that is in the wharf with cement. By the time they get judgment in 7 years, the cement is all caked and it's all gone bad. All the container of fish, is it fish or fishes that are that are, you know, lying there. So ADR can help them, you know, get quick result. That's number one for commercial people. Then generally also, you mentioned that the courts have also now seen the need for setting up a system to push some cases which can be resolved through ADR. I've got with me here, you know, this is Anambra State has a multi-door courthouse practice directions and rules 2019. Anambra State has like five doors, multi-door. I think that's why it's called multi-door.
Doors, yes,
so
doors.
There are different doors. Edo State has an ADR center. Edo State of Nigeria also has its own. I know Delta has and other states. And then Lagos also has, you know, several. I think Lagos has about five or so doors. So Abuja has, etc.
Yes.
So this is now becoming a facet of the court system.
Yes.
So now let's look at who can refer matters to ADR. In other words, who can look at a case and say, this case should go for alternative dispute resolution. Let them go there and sort themselves out.
Okay. Like I earlier said, parties can identify and elect to go for ADR system.
So number one,
The parties can on their own, maybe via their original contract,
okay,
or in the means of their disputes.
Yes.
They can resolve by themselves. So parties have to be aware that they can go to the ADR centers by themselves.
Okay, that's number one.
That's number one.
Yes.
Number two, because of the very nature of our environment, we still have traditional systems that are relevant. So, especially here in Edo State, Benin City, parties still go to the traditional institution,
okay,
to resolve their disputes.
Yes.
So when they go to the traditional institutions to resolve their dispute, it is not unheard of that these traditional institutions haven't critically looked at the nature of the dispute, referred them to the multi-door centers for better resolution.
Okay.
So that will depend on the nature of the dispute involved. So if it's not very traditional inclined,
yes,
the traditional ruler will just refer them to the multi-door courthouse. Then sometimes when matters are filed in court,
yes,
when it passes through the CJ for referral to the different judges in court,
the CJ now being the chief judge of the state, okay,
yes, the chief judge can look at the matter and say, oh, this matter is very sensitive, this matter is time bound, and the nature of this dispute, we need speedy resolution. So the CJ can, by their office,
yes,
refer the matter to the multi-door courthouse. Then sometimes the matter would have even reached the judge in court.
Okay.
And the judge just look at the matter and say, okay, it would be better for this matter to go to the ADRO center. So
okay,
the judges too can refer. So from what we have said, we are saying that Either the parties, traditional institutions,
the chief judge,
the judge sitting in court can refer matters to the ADR.
Okay, so, all right.
Sorry, before we miss it finally.
Yes.
Even lawyers who are being briefed.
Okay.
Yes, can listen to their clients and instead of recommending litigation, can recommend that the matter goes to ADR too.
So this is actually something that lawyers should really contemplate as an option when taking briefs from their clients. They should also think, okay, can this matter be resolved through ADR, my client's problem, instead of going to court, I refer him on to ADR or ask him to do ADR?
Well, it has almost become mandatory,
okay,
for every lawyer to first of all examine the matter and suggest an alternative means of dispute resolution.
It's always become
most states
become
already have it in their high court rules.
Yes,
their rules, their court, the various court, even their magistrate court rules.
Yes.
So first of all, evaluate the case and advise the parties on other means of dispute resolution other than litigation.
So in Edo State, I think it's Form 6, Certificate of Pre-Action Counseling.
Yes.
So a lawyer must sign that, you know, we have advised him. Lagos also has that. He went all the way to the Court of Appeal,
yes,
where the Court of Appeal said, if you don't have that form, you know, it could be,
yes,
it could be a game nullifier for you. You could get the case struck out. Now, the one of lawyers, everybody understands that. If a client comes to my office, I can ask him, look, do you think you like to do it the out? That's understandable. Judges, a matter is before them. They look at it. This matter now, this is not, it's taking too long. Can you people not, particularly families, your husband, your wife, or your children of the same parents? There was a matter in court where it was the son that took the mother to court over property. You know, the son sued the mother, you know, in court. So such scenarios, the judge can refer that. I think that doesn't present any problem for any viewer. Then the chief judge, you know, can do ADR screening. You know, when a case is filed, before she assigns it to a judge, she can look at it and say, but this matter, can you then go and try and resolve? The one I think that I would need you to explain a little bit more, if you don't mind, is the one where you said, you know, parties can contemplate it in their contract. Because you already have two parties that are at odds with each other. They're already quarreling. I supplied you with 10 trailer loads of cement. You have refused to pay me. Give me my money. The other one says, no, it was not 10, or it was 10, but the one you brought, some of them were bad. So there's already parties at odds. So at what point can the parties now sit down and say, oh, God, you know what? Let us not quarrel. Let's not go to court. Let's go to ADR. I mean, is that realistic?
It actually doesn't sound realistic.
Okay.
There is an adage in Benin that says, when we are laughing,
yes,
we do not think we will quarrel.
Okay.
So I think that is the bane of writing contracts. Contracts are a way of documenting agreements.
Okay.
So while you are anticipating a business boom,
yeah,
there is, for us commercial lawyers,
yes,
there is something that is very fundamental that will tell you at the point of drafting your contract, the law that governs your contract. So for every aptly written contract document, there is a law that governs that contract, so that when relationship deteriorates, that law becomes the extant law for that contract. So when parties are at the point where they get into the contract initially, that's where they are informed about the various means of dispute resolution. And because for commercial parties, time is always of the essence.
Yes.
They usually opt for ADRO systems.
Okay.
Because at that point, they are already educated as to how the ADRO system works.
Okay.
So when dispute eventually arises,
yes,
which it normally does,
yes,
they already know. Initially, when ADRO started becoming popular in Nigeria, at the point of dispute, you still have some commercial party run to court.
Okay.
So when they get to court, the judges then say, you hear the other party say, no, we are objecting to the jurisdiction of this court because we already have an ADRO clause in our contract.
Okay.
That time it was really, really very troublesome because some judges did not even understand the purpose of the ADRO clause in the contract. They saw it as an ouster clause,
okay,
of the jurisdiction of the court.
Okay.
And so they will want to uphold the matter.
Ouster now meaning, sorry to interrupt, because of my viewers.
Yes.
Ouster meaning a clause in a law that removes jurisdiction of the court.
That's so, more like a clause that says that a court
should not
cannot
hear the matter.
Cannot hear a matter.
Okay.
So it sounds like an affront on the court.
Okay.
So the judge will want to uphold the jurisdiction of their court.
Okay.
But as time went on, through training and retraining, they got to understand that it was not an ouster of the judge's jurisdiction, or rather the court's jurisdiction, but it was a means of enhancing the judge's jurisdiction by reducing the workload on the court, more like deburdening the court of unnecessary matters. So gradually, the judges and the judiciary generally started accepting the ADRU clauses that came with the contract.
Okay, so in summary, what my understanding, correct me if I'm wrong, what you have said is that parties, when preparing their contract, yes. So you said, yes. If we are laughing, we will not think we will quarrel.
Yes.
So at the point at which we are laughing, yes, okay, I want to supply you with 10 trailer loads of cement, I'm bringing it so day, you are going to pay me so day. So a lawyer prepare the agreement. Mm. So at the point of preparing the agreement, it is then that they should put a clause, say, in case we have a quarrel.
Oh, them to say, when you quarrel,
in case you quarrel, they will say, we're not going to quarrel, it's my friend. Mm. This man is my friend. Okay, we have been doing business for years. Mm-hmm. We have never quarreled.
So what if his trailer gets spoiled and is unable to supply your 10 bags of cement? What would then happen? Then he remembers and says, that's true.
Okay.
I will lose money, you will lose money. So let's put it down in writing. If you fail to supply my trailer load of cement,
yes,
and we are quarreling over what you will pay me as damages,
yes,
instead of going to the court to decide who is going to pay who damages,
yes,
let this man be our neutral
to help us resolve the matter quickly.
Yes.
Okay, so what you have said, which I will take away today, is, and I'm sure lawyers also watch this, respectfully, judges also watch this, and magistrates, every contract should contain a resolution clause. Is there a resolution? ADR?
A governing law, actually.
So the governing law
now defines which particular means of resolution you want.
When you say governing law, you see like laws of those state or laws of
it's all
laws of Ondo state
the
conciliation and arbitration act.
Okay. The governing law will normally say something like this: should a dispute arise out of this contract,
yes,
the laws of the Federal Republic of Nigeria,
yes,
will be the governing law for this contract.
Okay.
Specifically,
yes,
its arbitration and conciliatory act will rule over this contract.
Yes.
Then you now go down to now analyze whether you want it to be one arbitrator or whether you want it to be a mediator, in what state you want it to be heard.
Okay.
The language that should be used during the mediation session.
Yes. So
that's the governing law. So it's all encompassed.
This governing law clause you recommend should be in every contract.
Yes.
Because most contracts don't have it.
I think specifically I would recommend it for your landlord and tenant agreement.
Okay, you know, landlord and tenant agreement, because they usually don't have the most troublesome
contract that is being
drafted. They don't have it. What about land purchase agreements?
Yes.
You know, I'm buying land, you are selling land.
It should be in every contract.
It should
contract.
Be in that one too.
I just made a joke out of the landlord and tenant because they are so troublesome. They are always so troublesome.
Yeah. Commercial agreements.
Yes, commercial agreement should have
also have this. So that in case, we are not praying it should happen, but in case it happens,
a dispute arises,
then, you know, they can easily do arbitration and then resolve and remain business partners or friends, you know, going forward. Instead of the long litigation that, you know, goes into cross-examination, you ask me question, you know, there was a case where somebody had to cross-examine his opponent, and then he said to him, oh, when you have problem with your wife, am I not the one you always run to resolve it? And the person said, yes. When your wife caught you with a side chick, so time, was I not the one that resolved it? And then so he started delving into
very private
and very personal. And then you had the person, you know, reduced to tears and were like, this man, you know, you're asking me all of these questions. So litigation really is, you know, a hard, you know, punching one. But you have said ADR, we leave everybody with, you know, both sides feeling that they want something.
Yes.
So ADR seeks to find a common sort of ground for resolving, for solution, like a settlement thing, not necessarily one person winning or the other person winning.
Yes.
Although in reality, one person will go away, you know,
a little
happier than the other.
Yes.
Okay, so if the matter is already in court, as we are speaking now, there are obviously lots of matters in court. For one person to decide that like you said, lawyers or their clients, parties can decide, okay, let's go to ADR. Will it not be a sign of weakness if one party decides, okay, my lord, can we go to ADR? Will the other party not feel, it's because he sees that I'm going to win. That's why he wants us to go to ADR.
That's how the party who is not very knowledgeable about ADR, that's how he will normally feel. Okay. But the truth is, the other person might have had some ADR knowledge or experience, and if he properly enlightens the other party,
yes,
the other party will be able to understand where he's coming from. Say, for example, like I was speaking to you the other day, and you told me the money spent on litigation,
yes,
cannot exactly be quantified.
Yes.
If he had seen, for example, his parents had that matter and they were in court,
yes,
while he was a child,
yes,
then he now has started pursuing that matter as an adult.
Yes.
The money his parents would have spent all that time,
yes,
when they were in court,
yes,
now they have handed over the case to him.
Mm-hmm.
Not just physical money.
Yes.
Sometimes time.
Time. Okay.
Parties have to travel, say, from Lagos to Benin, yes, Abuja to Benin. Time. Time spent on the road. Sometimes parties have to sit in court endlessly for their matters to be called. Sometimes they even come to court and the court is not sitting.
Mm-hmm.
All this time cannot really be quantified into money.
Okay.
So if he sees it from the point of view of, I'm losing so much money, so are you.
Yes.
Sometimes at the end of the day, the judgment sum will not be able to pay for money and time lost.
Okay.
Then the relationship that eventually breaks down, that may not be repairable.
Mm.
If he has seen it from that point of view, he can actually approach the other person and say, okay, it's just the same way some people come to court and say, I don't want to go to court, I don't want to go to the high court because the high court is already full.
Mm-hmm.
I want my matter heard in the magistrate court.
Okay.
And the magistrate court has financial limitations.
Yes.
And he says, okay, I'll write off the rest.
Okay. Yes.
He's talking about millions. He just says, I'll write off the rest, go to the magistrate court, fix the remaining small one for me. It's the same consideration. He has evaluated the time he's going to spend in court might be equivalent or more than the one he's writing off. So rather than spend that time, he just writes off the other one and moves forward. So it doesn't show a sign of weakness. It actually shows it a sign of someone who is diligent with his time and has a focus of what he wants to get.
Okay, we're going to take a very, very short break. We're talking about how to get quick justice without spending many years in court. I'm talking with Erakoba Elavare. I insist on calling your first name first. All right, so we're going to take a short break and we'll be right back. But if you have not subscribed to Pinnacle TV YouTube channel, you need to subscribe. You need to click the notification bell so that when we post videos, you can receive it, you know, immediately. And then you need to also share the videos and give us, you know, the thumbs up, like. So we'll be right back. Don't go away. 24 hours, 7 days a week. You can find your favorite program, Law and You, only on Pinnacle TV. All right, welcome back. We're talking about how to get quick justice without spending many years in court. And again, I'm talking with Erakoba Elavare Esquire. Very, very highly educated, LLM commercial and maritime law. That's a deep one. And then an associate, Chartered Institute of Arbitrators, UK and Nigeria. So, which kind of cases can really go for ADR? Is it all cases? Human rights, land law matters, you know, banker customer relationship problems, commercial disputes, everyone, anyone can go to ADR?
No. Initially, ADR was strictly for commercial parties, especially international commercial parties.
Okay.
But as time went on, more dispute parties clamored to join the train because of its speed. and the fact that it's cheaper in the long run to litigation. So then it was reduced to non-contentious matter.
Okay.
So matters that are contentious in nature and matters that are within the purview of the state, like criminal matters, are not subject to ADR.
Okay.
So even family matters like divorce,
still
not subject to ADR, because the law that regulates matrimonial causes is has its own guideline for how matrimonial issues should be resolved and has not been brought within the purview of ADR. So family matters like divorce have not been brought under the purview of ADR, but issues like maintenance for children can actually fit into the ADR system.
Property disputes between husband and wife can go to ADR. Who gets which house? Do I give you a house? Property dispute between families.
Not property dispute that touches on the title of the property.
Okay.
Say property disputes in a sale and resale.
Okay.
That touches on the title of the property. That's
where it will require complicated evidence.
Very contentious. Okay. So that will not.
But generally speaking, where both parties agree, they can actually, except where there's a specific, like in the divorce situation,
yes,
where the
specific
law that says you got to do it in open court, you got to hear the evidence in open court.
Yes.
Generally, parties can decide, let's go to ADR, unless the court say, no, you can't do ADR. So you are watching now, if you have a case and you think, it's been years in court, and you want to give ADR a try,
you can just apply.
You can just apply to the court.
Stay the proceedings. Why you try ADR?
Now there's also another point that in law, when you adopt the ADR system, it stays the limitation provisions.
Yes.
So people shouldn't be worried about that. Oh, if I go to ADR now, it doesn't work. I may lose my. So if ADR doesn't work, people still can go back to the litigation if they refuse to cooperate. And at the end,
that's for a court centric ADR system.
That's for a court centric ADR.
So
okay.
What we mean by that is that's for an ADR system that was referred from the courts.
Okay.
If originally you went directly to ADR, it still does not affect your right to further seek redress.
Okay.
If say for example, during the ADR system, one party just suddenly stops appearing.
Yes. Okay.
When the dispute has not been resolved.
Yes.
So as aggrieved party, you will still need a different means of enforcing whatever it is on that party.
Okay.
So you may now still be able to go to court when the ADR system fails.
Fails. Okay. So ADR system is there, but if it doesn't work by virtue either of the non-cooperation of both parties or by virtue of the subject matter, then parties can go back to court and go for the long go for the long haul, if I put it like that. Okay, so with that, about which cases qualify for ADR. Now, who handles ADR? This is something I'm sure people want to know. I mean, is it like, okay, I get there to ADR. Ah, it's the same judge now. It's not the same judge that I was before yesterday who refused to say we should go to ADR. She's also the one here. So why didn't we just do it in her court?
ADR matters.
Did you say no or yes?
I said no.
Okay.
ADR matters are handled by specially trained practitioners. So skilled professionals in the field of ADR, they are not only lawyers or judges, but people, professionals who have the skills, who have been trained to handle ADR matters. Say for example, when I was training to become an arbitrator, there were some people in my class, they were architects.
Okay.
Some were doctors.
Okay.
Some were accountants, some were engineers. So they train to become ADRO specialists in their field.
Okay.
So when you have disputes within, maybe like some things are not very common here in Benin City or even in Nigeria, where you want to build a house, you get an engineer and you have the construction contract
Yes.
that tells you how much material you will need to build your house,
yes,
what time frame your house, in what time frame your house will be ready,
yes,
and so on and so forth.
Yes.
It's called a construction agreement.
Yes.
Yes. So if, for example, there is a dispute arising out of a construction agreement,
yes,
an engineer who is an ADR specialist will be able to, will be best suited to sit over that dispute than a proper lawyer,
okay,
without a construction
Background or experience
background
or knowledge.
Experience.
Okay.
So the ADR system admits of different professionals,
mm-hmm,
who are skilled in the process of administering.
And these people will be neutral. They are not.
Yes.
They are not biased.
No.
They don't have any interest at all.
They are just like judges in court who are neutral to
who
the
are
matter.
Also neutral to,
yes,
the matter.
But they are trained to become professional and neutrals.
But if I get there and I find out that the man who is going to be the ADR man is related to my opponent, there's opportunity for me to say no, or
okay,
I can't let it. Is
that depends on how the neutral comes to be.
Assuming, you know,
sometimes,
yes,
if you elect a neutral via your contract,
yes,
it means that prior to that time you have already elected the neutral.
Okay.
You can elect your neutral, the other party can elect his neutral, both neutrals can elect one single neutral.
Yes.
Then you can go to an institution like the Nigerian Institution of Professional Engineers.
Yes.
You can go there and say, you go to their ADR center and say you want a neutral. Then they give you a neutral that suits your purpose. But what he is saying is, if for any reason,
yes,
either the neutral that has been chosen on your behalf,
yes,
is related to either of you, or is somewhat connected to the matter,
yes,
yes, just like the normal court, you have the right to object and say, or even the neutral has the right to debrief himself,
okay,
and say, okay, because of my relationship with these people,
yes,
or with the matter, I,
yes,
will not be able to hear their matter.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, cool. Now just a few more and then I'll let you go. Does it lead to loss of job opportunity for lawyers? Because me as a lawyer, I don't want I don't want a system that will render me, and I'm sure lawyers think like that, render them totally irrelevant or losing money. So does ADR actually lead lawyers to lose money, or does it have a way to help lawyers still make money?
It doesn't lead to loss of job. It only enhances our job. Like lawyers, we're already used to reading and reading and reading. So
yes,
it's just an additional read for a lawyer.
Okay, an additional read.
Yes. So it's just every lawyer that wants to stay relevant,
yes,
does the needful to stay relevant. So
okay,
every new area of law that comes up, you quickly get yourself abreast with it. So it's just an issue of training and continuous training for the lawyer. Because now, even if prior to this time, you elect to practice ADR or not.
Yes.
But now that there is now a court-centric ADR system,
yes,
you there are is not, really nothing any lawyer can do other than get themselves abreast with the system.
Okay. Okay. So lawyers, you heard that, you better go and get yourself, trained and retrained in ADR. Otherwise, now let's look at timelines, because the purpose of this show is to enlighten people how they can get quick justice without spending many years in court. And the proposition is that, okay, I don't like speaking big English on this show, so what we're saying is, if people elect to do alternative dispute resolution, which is ADR, instead of going the law side, it's possible their case can be resolved quicker. What is the timeline usually, traditionally or customarily, or from experience, court-centered one, the court has referred it, plus minus, how many years, how many months, how many weeks?
No matter how long it takes, it will not be as long as a traditional court system.
Okay.
The reason being that every ADR rule,
yes,
has timeline for everything. Contracts, how do I put it now? Contract-centered ADR are even more time-framed than any other kind of ADR election, because by contract you have already said negotiations between parties will stay for 3 days.
Okay.
Should negotiation within party fail within 3 days,
mm-hmm,
within 7 days,
yes,
the neutral arbitrator or mediator or conciliator should be contacted. Within 7 days of contacting the neutral, parties should submit their bond.
So all this would have been provided in the contract?
Yes, in your contract.
Okay. So before parties even sign, before they start their contract.
So contract provided ADRO system is really faster.
Okay.
Because by your contract, you have already specified. And a breach of any of those time frame can actually nullify the whole process.
Okay.
Yes. But for court-centric ADRO system, like the ones I have been opportunity to witness in court, the judge says, I'm referring you to the multi-door courthouse.
Yes.
And I'm giving you a timeline of 6 months to resolve.
Okay.
Should you not be able to resolve within 6 months, you return back to court for continuation.
So we're looking at about 6 months.
Yes,
the court says try and resolve it within 6 months.
Whichever process of ADRO that has been adopted.
Yes, must get a result within that period.
There is usually a timeline for everything.
Okay, that's beautiful. I think we've done justice to it. Enforcement of arbitral awards. I think that's the one that. So now, you know, our people, after judgment, even if they cooperated, even if they signed to it, at the end they say, I beg, I'm not interested in. I don't want to hear that matter anymore. You know, that cost me so much. So how can ADR awards, arbitral awards, be enforced? Is it the neutral, the conciliator, the arbitrator that now will carry a cane and or a whip and go and whip the other party and say, you know, comply? Or how?
Ordinarily.
Yes.
Especially the contract-centered ADRO system.
Yes.
Parties are bound by the decision of the neutral.
Okay.
Then, along the line, because of the way some people behave, they don't behave like commercial parties. We started having the court-adopted awards.
Court-adopted awards, okay.
But sincerely, it will depend on the parties to enforce their awards.
Okay.
Why do I say this? The biggest ADRO case that we have had in Nigeria that has really established the ADRO process, or really made the ADRO process and the court process more public, is the boycotting matter.
Okay.
When the boycotting had a problem with federal government, their rules, their contracts already stated that should they have a problem with the contract, the ADRO system will sit over the matter.
Yes.
So when the contract broke down, one party went to institute the ADRO process.
Yes.
While the other party went to court.
Okay.
That was the same case where they had to challenge the ouster clause and the jurisdiction, or they debated about the ouster clause and the jurisdiction clause.
Yes, in court.
In court.
Yes.
So after a long court session debating on whether the court had jurisdiction or not, the court finally held that they did not have jurisdiction.
Okay.
At every point, they all got to Supreme Court.
Wow.
So they had to, the court eventually held that they did not have jurisdiction because there was already an ADRO clause in the contract.
Yes.
So they went back to pursue ADRO.
Okay.
When they pursued ADRO and one party got to judgment, the other party refused to enforce the judgment.
Okay.
And so the other party, who initially went to ADRO, then went back to court to try to get enforcement from the court.
Yes.
And the court eventually now said they had jurisdiction to ask the other party to enforce the awards, that the award is binding because the contract says the awards is binding on them. So they left the court and then went back to ADRO section again to start to think of how they want to enforce the awards.
Okay.
The truth is, this should not be.
Okay.
The other time when I was in court, when the court was referring a matter for ADRO, the lawyers involved actually begged the court, saying that once they get an award from the neutral, they would like to bring the award back to court, so that the courts will now enroll it as a court order.
Okay.
This shouldn't be. Reason being that an ADRO award is as good as a valid court award. So I think from time to time, the judges should start to re-emphasize that point, that parties are bound by the decisions or the awards of the neutrals.
Okay, so bottom line is ADR awards, if one party does not comply, can still be taken back to court.
Currently, that is what it is now.
The normal process. Everybody should, we've gone to ADR, we have agreed, we have signed to it, everybody should comply. But if for any reason they do not comply, of course, the court, it now becomes an enforceable court issue. You already have a judgment which the court can register and then enforce. If you have any comments or any questions at all, leave your comment in the comment section. And then we'll get back to you. And if you have not subscribed, this is the point at which I'll ask you again, subscribe. You need to subscribe. And I want to thank you, Erakuba. I hope I pronounce it well, Erakuba Ilevare. Thank you very much for coming on the show. You are an arbitrator.
Yes,
so you can actually sit to decide, cases.
Yes.
Wow, more like a judge.
My pleasure.
Thank you for coming
on
the show. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed it, please say something nice in your comments about Erakuba Library. I'd like to hear what you have to say about it. And then if you have cases you think should go for ADR, if you have spent some time in court, you now know what to do. Get your lawyers to tell the judge. Please send us to ADR. And if you have any questions, again, I say leave your question in the comment section and then we'll get back to you. Thank you very much. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
24 hours, 7 days a week. You can find your favorite program, Law and You, only on Pinnacle TV.